Hey, Chief, thank you. I enjoyed our phone conversation. I know there's been a call, discussion of this recently, earlier, but tell me, as regards immunization, why are we not requiring those who are being allowed to come into the United States to be vaccinated for COVID before being released into the United States, particularly in the context that the Biden administration is asking anyone that has a nexus with federal government to require their employees to get vaccinated? I'm not quite sure I understand the exception for those who are being allowed to come here illegally.
Senator, thank you for the question. And actually, I think any of those individuals, migrants coming into the country, should be immunized.
Thank you. And is should be required to be immunized as a condition of being allowed to continue?
Senator, that's something I definitely want to explore. It seems reasonable to me.
Okay. A couple other issues. Your law enforcement background is without parallel. Let me ask, though, on the other issues. For example, we discussed Jones Act. CBP has jurisdiction over Jones Act, trade-based money laundering. What will you do, if you will, for those areas that, if you will, are kind of gaps in your background, but nonetheless an important portion of the CBP mission?
Senator, thank you for the question. I have to tell you, I know that perhaps the assumption has been made that I would be more interested in the border and those functions as opposed to the trade functions of CBP, but I want to assure you the trade functions are an area where I'm both extremely interested and want to commit to learning as much as possible. The Jones Act, I'm sure you realize better than most, is incredibly complex. I am doing my best to learn about it.
Now, can I ask, because inevitably you'll need a lieutenant who is going to be in charge of that, just because, I mean, your plate will be full just with the border. So do you have the ability to hire your own lieutenants, or will there be someone there who will make this a priority within the considerations of the department? Knowing that you're making an effort to learn, but knowing that the highly technical aspect of it will require somebody with expertise.
Senator, thank you for the question. And one of the great things about the process that I've gone through over the last several months is to learn about the number of highly knowledgeable, highly dedicated personnel.
I'm taking that as a yes.
Grade. So you are 100% right.
Yes. In your testimony, you had a paragraph regarding the desire to address the issue of forced labor. Now, of course, I would advocate that that be second and third degree. There's been a big push in this committee to support battery technology. It's pretty clear that cobalt is being taken out of the Congo using forced labor, which is being employed, if you will, by Chinese companies. It's been pretty well documented. There's a New Yorker article about it. There's others in the press. I had promoted an amendment that was rejected on party lines that that we would ask that cobalt being used in batteries be ensured not to come from forced labor. To what degree does your commitment to addressing the use of forced labor include the kind of second degree? It isn't where the battery is being made, but it is where the cobalt is being mined to be used in the battery.
Senator, thank you for the commitment, and I would just mention that forced labor is really something I'd like to consider as a top trade
price. But that would be a second degree issue as well, not just China where it's being used with the Uyghurs, but also in Congo where it's being used to harvest the cobalt?
Absolutely.
And to put a point on it, it would bring you a little bit in conflict with the emphasis on other parts of the administration to use battery technology, which requires the use of this forced labor mined cobalt. Are you willing to take on that political battle?
Senator, it would certainly be something I'd want to learn more about, obviously, because right
Yes, but if you, and I don't mean to interrupt, I just have 40 seconds left. If you're going to take on forced labor, I can tell you it's hard with the emphasis upon battery technology to take it on, because there is just a lot of folks who want to put head in sand and not notice about child labor being in the Congo, being used by Chinese companies to take the cobalt to be making these batteries. So simple answer, you may decide that, no, you don't want to engage in it, but if it turns out what I'm saying is correct, will you take that issue on?
Yes, I will. It sounds like a very important situation.
Thank you, and I'll yield back. I just say that, and I thank you for your testimony.